competition points here tonight to try and achieve that. Let's bring you the sides. Well, round 18's defeat for Wigan at Hull FC has blown the competition wide open. They have been forced into a single change. There is no Adam Kieran, who during the week failed a head injury assessment, so Liam Farrell will deputise in the centres. Harvey Hill brought onto the bench as Sam Walters moves from the bench into Farrell's back row position. Well, Warrington beat St Helens 24-10 last time out. It came at a cost, though. James Harrison suspended after his red card, and Stefan Ratchford went off with an injury. He has not been able to recover in time. Josh Toulis comes back on the bench. That pushes Aaron Lindop into the centres. And on the bench comes Max Wood alongside Jordy Crowther, Zane Musgrove and Danny Walker. Well, in the hunt for the league leader's shield, it's the Wigan Warriors who are looking for a seventh title and the Warrington Wolves a third. We've touched on Matt Duffy already, the Warrington Wolves' top try scorer. Liam Marshall will be looking to get back try scoring for the Wigan Warriors.
Yeah, without doubt, with me and Kev were just talking, he often relies upon French and Field for those assists for his tries, but an incredible finisher, Kev.
Yeah, he's almost underrated because how good and how much we talk about Field and French, but Marshall, in his own right, if he gets half a chance, and looking at the grass behind us, he is going to be lightning across the turf tonight. You don't have to look far for a try if you've got Marsh in there.
It's such good conditions for a game like this. Two top sides going at it. It's perfect.
Two top sides. Pitch looks brilliant. The sunshine's out, and I think the PA system is working. Everything is going our way tonight here on Sky Sports. And the Warrington Wolves fans, well, they've travelled not a great distance, but in decent numbers. Remember, at the end of tonight, we may have three sides at the top of the table, all on 28 points. It would take a Warrington win here against the Wigan Warriors and a Hull KR win against London. A game we're also covering on Sky Sports, as well as St Helens against Lee. Well, we are ready for action. The teams standing by. Former teammates George Williams and Liam Farrell now in opposition camps. The next 80 minutes of action may go a long way towards determining the destination of this year's League Leaders Shield.
We could be on the verge of watching one of the modern great games of rugby league.
Fine margins determine big games. He gets it away to Nicholson!
And Nsenda rocking and rolling his way through.
Boy, we've got a ball to pick down.
Oh, this is what Friday nights on Sky Sports are all about. First v second, the champions, the Wigan Warriors, against a side who are so desperate to get back to Old Trafford and finally lift the trophy they crave so much. Will it be their year? Nothing they haven't heard before, but they do look different under head coach Sam Burgess, John Wilkin and Kevin Brown.
They do completely different. They've got that resilience, they back the defence, and I think tonight they come here really, really confident. They're going to move the ball around, and for me, I think Warrington are going to just get the win.
Yeah, I fancy Warrington, but we're going to hurt it from last week, and they're massive, and they're going to come firing into Warrington. I just think Warrington are going to be too good.
You pair are licking your lips, certainly. The players lining up now. And we will not be far away from a minute's applause, because it has been a very sad week for us at Sky Sports, and indeed for Rugby League and the media that covers this great game, as we lost Bill Arthur, our long-serving commentator. Bill, of course, after the retirement of Eddie Hemmings, covered the last five grand finals, a very distinguished broadcaster who held a number of roles throughout his near three decades with Sky Sports. He is much missed by all of his colleagues here at Sky Sports, and of course by his wife Cherry, his children Simon, Meredith, Kit and Nancy. To them we send our love. We miss Bill, and the game of rugby league over this round will pay their tributes to one of the great broadcasters to cover what we call the greatest game. Bill Arthur from Sky Sports, missed by all and never to be forgotten. All clubs from the Betfred Super League, and indeed all the divisions, have sent messages throughout the week on social media to Bill's family, all gratefully received by Cherry and the children.
late Bill Arthur. Let's go over to our commentary team for tonight's game. The first second clash of the Wigan Warriors and Warrington Wolves. Turi O'Connor and Dave Woods.
Thank you, Brian. And to add to the many, many wonderful tributes to Bill, in 30 years of knowing him, every single memory is positive, coloured by his warmth, his generosity of spirit, his love and passion for this sport at all levels. We've lost a lovely, lovely bloke and a wonderful broadcaster, and he will be missed by so many. Well, he'd have loved what's on offer tonight, he really would. A night when Wigan starts in top spot, but in a couple of hours, any one of the Warriors, Warrington or Hull Kingston Rovers could be league leaders. We thought the race for top spot was over a couple of weeks ago. Wigan looked unmovable, but that shock defeat against Hull last week just opened things. They started that game with mistakes. They started this game with mistakes, Terry.
Look, incredible. These are two of the standout teams for me this year. And Liam Byrne gets a chance starting, only averaging 24 minutes a game over his 10 games he's played this year, makes the error. I thought that looking at the teams, that Wigan are going to go after Warrington up front. Well, it's Warrington who started very strong, very aggressive, got into Liam Byrne and forced the first mistake of this game.
Well, Matt Peat was very strong in the week, saying about it is all about starting well and building on the back of that. Well, this is just about the worst possible start, because suddenly Warrington, in these opening moments, have an opportunity to build pressure on the Wigan line. Drinkwater puts it in. Out it comes to Williams. The pass is not the best, so his threat is immediately neutralised. But there's more to come. Powell, the former Wigan man, puts it back on the inside. Nicholson will drive it in. So wonderful atmosphere here tonight. Just seems every weekend there's a big game, and this is another one. Warrington close. This is Powell moving it right. Switch of decision and angle of attack. Dufty, nowhere to go. Close down. Absolutely nowhere to go. Wigan's defence doing well. But this is going to be Ty, who puts it on to Williams, and now Vaughan, and Vaughan tries to push his way through, but held up with one play to go. What an opening set for Warrington. Can they turn it into something glorious now? On to Wigan, hold out. William goes left. Dufty puts the kick into the in-goal area. Chased and scored by Aaron Lindott. What a start. What a start to such a big game. Warrington up and running like lightning.
Well, incredible start for them. Some dominant defence from Warrington at the start of this game. I think it was Luke Yates who forced the error on big Liam Byrne. Aaron Lindock scores the try. You can just see he gets underneath it. Curry's involved. Also, Paul Vaughan's involved. Last week against Saints, Warrington scored on the first shift that they had in the first set of six. A nice, delicate kick from Matt Dufty to the youngster, Aaron Lindock, who scores only on his fifth Super League appearance. Starting in the centre, his long-term future for me will be in the centre. Played for England Academy in the centre. I think he's a quality youngster, and what a start for Warrington.
Well, he made his mark, didn't he, the very first night, very first weekend of Super League, when he scored on his debut in Catalan for Warrington. Just put up notice that he's a young star to watch. And there's a big try in a big moment. And Josh Fewlis, in the absence, of course, of Stephen Ratchford, missing because of that horrific facial injury last week.
1 minute.
So Fewlis takes over the kicking duties. No stranger, of course, to that task. 29 out of 36 so far he's landed this season. South stand into which he's kicking is swathed in sunshine, but is hushed because that's where the Wigan fans are watching now. And up go the flags. And Warrington leading by 6 points to nil.
Well, that is a great start for Sam Burgess and his side. And it poor start from Matty Peat. John Wilkins said before the game, 16 errors they made last week. Wigan, well, they started with the first error of the game, leads to that try. And Warrington so clinical when they move the ball from right to left. George Williams is key And Dufty, nice kick for the youngster.
So Wigan barely touched the ball, but have made a mistake and are now looking to reset the balance at the other end by putting pressure on Warrington's ball carriers, Dave, as they try to bring it clear.
And you know what's coming in this set of six if you're a Warrington player. The most important thing you've got to do is word the tackle, because you know it's coming out the line. You've got to get to your kick and just start building into your sets again.
Powell.
No, play ball, go third.
Picking up from the heels of Yates and driven on again. Warrington creeping their way back to where they want to be. But it is only step by step at the moment as Wigan's defence puts up that iron curtain.
Move! Straight out.
One play to go. Switched back to Drinkwater, who gets the kick away. Miski is underneath that and catches safely and scampers back as quickly as he can to get back to the best ground possible.
Well, good initial contact from Sam Powell, just trying to stop Miski. No important. The likes of Miski and Marshall on players one and two, bringing the ball away. So important that they press hard here and don't just sit back and defend on the heels.
Well, Farrell with a carry, playing in the centres tonight, of course. The right centres. Here's Thompson.
Four. Move, Adam. Come on. Hold. Go four.
Here's O'Neill. Puts it back to Ellis, who swings it across the line. And stretching back towards the middle goes Walters. Sam Walters. But they've hit the last, so it'll probably be a kick here from Harry Smith. And is, and up it goes, spiralling all around. Thewlis underneath it. Thewlis with a catch. Warrington start from there. Wigan in quickly.
Well, there's a lot of pressure, isn't there, on Harry Smith? He's going to have to lead an awful lot of things with youngsters. Zach Eckersley at fullback and Jack Ferrimon in the half-back partnership with him. So Warrington will try and get off the line and really take the game away from him. Nice run from Ashton, looking for behind the ruck earlier.
Well, part two of Warrington's big test, of course, covers 3 weeks. Last week was a big win against St Helens. Next week they go up against the potential league leaders, Hulkingston Rovers. Although there's a lot of rugby league to be played before OKR can claim that spot. And this one tonight, and early days of this one, they're very happy with the way that test is going. But Wigan will have a strike. Marshall collects, but a good chase. And Wigan are going to chase start from only 10 from their own line.
Yeah, that's a nice set of six from Warrington, just marching down the field, kicking the corner, kicking into the corner where the sun is going down on Marshall. Did ever so well to take that in these low-risk areas. Now Warrington cramming in nice and tight, just trying to get off the line.
Three.
Miski with a carry.
Goal three.
Up goes O'Neill into dummy half, and again, just pounding down the middle again here. Four. That's what they were saying beforehand, weren't they?
Hold Sam. Goal four.
As it stands, Wigan clear at the top, but only on points difference, of course.
Up now, play ball. Goal five.
And there's an injury for a Warrington player who's down there.
40.
Drinkwater it is, the kick finds Thewlis. Drinkwater's still on his knees as Thewlis brings it back. He's standing and walking now.
Paul,
he's involved in the tackle on Liam Byrne along with youngster Adam Holroyd. Obviously came out of it second best. Just getting some attention from the physio as he's trying to walk back.
Two, move straight out. On there, hold.
Now it's Powell. Try scorer Lindop. Heavy carry, but big push back, and the Wigan fans enjoyed that moment. A little roar of approval going up around most of the ground in response to that. Curry.
Four.
But they've only got a couple of plays left here, Warrington, in this set. Ward's gone left, but it comes right to Dufty. Dufty runs into a pair of them waiting. Tough stuff down the middle. So they're on the last now. Powell again waits, delivers it back to, and a little bit of a juggle from Drinkwater, but he does well to scramble away from the initial chase. The kick was not where he wanted it in the end, but he got away with one there. And Marshall brings it back.
Well, he does ever so well, doesn't he? He was under some pressure. He fumbled that ball, and then he thought for all money that he was going to get whacked. See the pressure from Thompson.
Two, move together. Paul.
Smith slotting in at dummy half. It is, as Kevin, Brian and John were suggesting beforehand, it is very much down the middle at the moment, isn't it?
Well, you're going to see how long the likes of Paul Vaughan and Luke Yates can do. Four prop forwards we're going to have gone with on the bench. A big overloaded bench from Matty Pete. Well, they get a penalty as well there now, contact with the head.
It's not forceful and dangerous in my
opinion. This is easy meters for the Warriors. And just as he goes in, just a swing over the top from Luke Yates.
Let's go, please.
You know, Warrington just don't want to be defending down here. Wigan, I'm sure, last week after that defeat, shock defeat as well. Let me be honest, but they were totally outplayed by Hull FC.
Plenty of leather on the ball from Harry Smith to carry his team midway inside their opponent's half. Byrne, whose first carry will still be rattling around in his memory banks.
Got one.
As it spilled and gave the opponents that opportunity.
Move back up.
Taken on by Thompson. Here's Eckersley. And it's lost by Walters. Wigan lose out again. They are making some mistakes early in this game.
Well, a couple of errors, like last week. I know we keep harping on them last week about how they played, but the completion rate was just 62%. Normally, they're ruthless, they're clinical, they're smart the way that they play. They were really sloppy last week, and a couple of early errors, and Matty Pete obviously frustrated at the minute.
Third.
That's Maud. And Warrington again. Almost ominously in possession. Yates adding that extra grind and grunt down the middle in his last couple of weeks. Saw his debut against St. Helens last week, of course. John Bateman to come back as well, we're told. Confirmed for next week. The kick is just about kept in play by Eckersley, and Warrington is still there with that vice-like grip to keep Wigan penned inside that 10. And Miskey now with a carry.
Well, that's it, they don't get the bounce that they wanted. It didn't go towards the touchline, but still not a bad place to turn the ball over. Look at this third tackle now, struggling for meters, just 20 meters from the line. Desperate for a quick play of the ball, Marshall.
O'Neill spinning it back, and Thompson blasts it forward, but four gone, two to go. And deep inside the wrong end of the ground from their point of view. Chance to move it on quickly there, but Farramond has his arms pinned to his chest, and the kick is from Smith.
40.
Over the top and bounces out of play. And it's a good kick. But Warrington will have possession, 10 from their own line. Well, in fact, it's a 40-20.
That's a great kick.
It's a fantastic kick.
Outstanding.
Play the ball to the boys, 40-20.
I don't think they realised that it was going to be a 40-20 then through this.
So suddenly, Wigan have this point of attack. And Walters will take it in.
Move, Paul, straight out.
So O'Neill waits at dummy half, and Wigan now are poised. They hope for something special. Ellis blasts forward. Defenders swinging him down and putting him down. O'Neill, Smith is missed, collected instead by Unsemba. Straightening things up, making it honest from that difficult starting position, and boy has he done well. But Warrington's defence just about doing a job. O'Neill, Ellis, Smith, Smith sees that Marshall is an option. And Liam Marshall, there to collect. What a season he's having. His prolific try scoring, and that is a big, big moment from Wigan's point of view.
You know, what about that? The 40-20, you kick into space, you give them a chance, you give them a couple of penalties, they've gone down there, they've had a crack, they haven't come off. Comes on the back of a 40-20, and Liam Marshall, well, he puts his hand in the air, he calls for it, and he gets it. Great kick from Harry Smith. You can see through this. Look, I don't think he expected that was going to be a 40-20, but nice play.
Yeah, loud and clear, mate.
He gets the call, a clear call from Marshall. Marshall puts the arm up, the ball's kicked. It's a pinpoint kick from Harry Smith. Like I said, he's going to have to pull all the strings and take some pressure off some of those youngsters. And what about that? That's how you react. That's the response that the coach is after.
Excellent, mate.
26th try of the season in all competitions, 20th in Super League. He leads that table. But if you add his Challenge Cup into that as well, 26, and this only his 22nd appearance, and that equals his most prolific try-scoring season back in 2022. He scored 26 in 26, so he's on a a much improved run this year, and that ain't going to be the end of his try scoring.
No, he's just a quality player, isn't he? He's so good at that end of the field, scoring tries, but I think he's exceptional bringing the ball away. And those big fellas in the middle of the field, the likes of Luke Thompson and Farrell, really respect the job that he does. He gets them on the front foot on play one, play two, and gives them the opportunity to win the next few plays to get down here.
So the Warrington fans behind the sticks trying to put Harry Smith off here. Watched him practicing drop goals, by the way, in the warm-up, which suggests how close this match could be, but he has pulled that wide. So Warrington remain in the lead, but only by two.
Well, the big thing for Wigan when he went behind on the scoreboard was don't panic, don't get frustrated, you'll get a chance, and that's the chance that they needed. Quality play, quality kick, Marshall's in. Warrington really had no answer to that. And then Wigan, after 14 minutes, they had to be a bit patient.
Okay.
And they get an opportunity and they take it.
So big boot again, and a restart, and Miskey will catch. Wigan will start here again with Byrne, with a challenge.
Picks out the same three blokes as well.
Here's Thompson.
Two.
Neil marching into Donny half. Just a blood and thunder down the guts here, isn't it? O'Neill's having a look round. Where's the next big fella to have a go? Well, in fact, they are going wider this time. Eckersley, though, closed down quickly by Lindop. Well read in defence by Aaron Lindop.
Yeah, good reads. Come up with a couple of good reads early on in the game.
40.
Smith again.
Luke, give 10.
Behind the 30. But a long, long way away from the touchline this time. And Lindop.
Sorry, Nick.
And back in position as Matt Duffy brings it back for Warrington.
Looking to sort the middle of the field up there.
Hulkingston Rovers leading 16-0 here. Over on Humberside in that big match. And still lead-nil St. Helens nil. Huge there as well. You know, St. Helens need to win to just to rebalance their season. Lee needing to win to keep up. Slim hopes of making the top six. Everywhere you look, every weekend of the season, there's a big story.
Seems to be there's a game, every game there's something to play for. Whether you're fighting to get in the top six or you're fighting to take the lead at the top of the table.
So here's Williams with a kick at the end of things. Eckersley catches safely enough. And Wigan start from there. 15 away from their own line. Here's Miskey now with a big carry.
Two. Move at it! Or two.
Smith again.
Good there.
Leith and Avard just onto the field. There's his first touch.
Held!
That's the first of your big fellas from the bench on.
Don't do me, Ethan! Don't do me!
Now it's Farrell.
Four. Move, Paul! Back in, Adam. Paul. Go four.
O'Neill. Now it's Thompson with another big gallop.
Five.
Bloodthirsty effort as ever from Luke Thompson. O'Neill on the last spins it out, and Smith puts his head down and goes for a little bit of a gallop, but he's got Curry for company, who got enough him to put the pressure on the kick, and that's given Warrington an opportunity here for Duffy to try and run through that broken Wigan line, but it recovers itself well enough.
Well, he's always looking for that fractured line, isn't he, Matt Duffy's electric speed at the back.
Come on, Brad.
The most meters in the competition this year.
Make it back, Luke.
Lindop.
Three. Move, Junior! Ball.
Here's Powell. Now Ball. He's putting his hand out as contact is made. We know how big meters he can be chewing up. Given any type of fall off by the defence, but not on that occasion. Williams to Duffy. Duffy stepping away. Duffy tantalising. And onto the last play here.
Hold. Goal five.
30 out. Williams again, the pass not the best. He has to go down to his knees to get that, but still puts up a very good kick that bounces awkwardly. And Eckersley just about recovers his poise, but concedes the dropout. And Wigan's nerves are tangible at the moment.
And again, they don't quite get it, but they're going for that little patch where the sun is. That 10-metre little strip. Good play. Instead of going to the big long side, they go to the short side. Eckersley couldn't get near it. A bit of panic from them. And the kicking game from Warrington, one of the best in the competition, with the likes of George Williams and Drinkwater.
10 seconds, Harry. Let's go. Shot clock off.
Well, some animated and intense conversations going on the gantry up here with
keep them low, boys.
Sam Burgess and his coaching team, and no doubt with Matt Peat and his coaching team, and some very intense stuff going on down there on the field as well.
Well, I think this is a big test for Warrington. This will tell us where they are in the season. Are they genuine, genuine contenders with so many players missing? George Williams, that man, he will take the battle to Wigan all day.
Power goes out of dummy half. Curry strains things up again. Look where they are. Two plays to go, and within sight of where they want to be. Drinkwater to Williams. Williams with a short pass. And that is a wonderful try from Adam Holroyd. Just opened up that Wigan defence. No wonder they're bouncing up and down with sheer delight. They might just be watching a champion team this year.
Well, he scored against St Helens last week, didn't he? Come up with it was on 71 minutes, really, when the game was just in the balance, was who's going to win. He come up with a try that just probably eased the nerves for Warrington. He's come up with another big play. But I'll trace that back to the play of the ball where Ben Curry, centre field, played the ball really quick. Then all of a sudden, Warrington are going on the front foot. Sam Powell comes out, clinical passing from him to Drinkwater, to Williams, and then to that young man, Adam Holroyd. Well, known as a really good, strong defensive player, but I tell you what, his try-scoring tally in the last couple of weeks isn't bad either.
There is a long, long way to go.
20 minutes, boys, let's just keep
but the opening quarter of this game is very much Warrington's.
Yeah.
10 points to 4.
Hello, mate.
With maybe another two to come. And the moods of both camps will contrast enormously at the moment.
Yeah, nervous. Both sets of players have got respect for each other, the coaching staff have, but well, it was always going to be one of those battles today of like who's going to just control their emotions. Really, both sets missing players.
Yeah,
who's going to front up? Who's going to step forward? If it was a Warrington player looking at that Wigan side, the 17, and you see the four prop forwards on the bench thinking, right, lads, they're coming for us up front. What are we going to do? We can't back down. We've got to take the battle to Wigan, and they're certainly doing that.
Big kick for Thewlis to give his side a two-score lead. Rocks back, rolls forward. Strikes it well, and the flags will confirm that it is a second success of the night from that goal-kicking team, and it is 12 points to 4 for Warrington.
Well, the set-up play from Curry, the nice soft hands from George Williams to Adam Holroyd, who just picks a really nice hole. The defenders fell for it. They were interested in what George Williams was doing, and he is a magnet, George Williams, and he creates space for that young man.
Well, some interesting stuff. Lee leading St Helens 6-0. Mark Percival is in the sin bin, apparently. And Jack Welsby has gone off injured in that game. So St Helens' injury woes just seem to stack up week on week. Early stages in that game, but early encouragement for the Leopards.
Hold, come on, Brad. Hold.
Warrington very much eyes on the prize here tonight and enjoying this battle. They want to get on with it, and it is a penalty. It's a flop. So it's a get-out-of-jail-free card for Warrington again with a penalty.
They weren't interested in getting in the battle in the middle of the field. George Williams trying to use his speed and get on the outside of Jack Wardle. The referee says the flop, just too much for them. And again, it's just like, get out of trouble, easy, with 20, 30 metres from the kick.
Well, last week, Wigan's performance against Hull littered with mistakes and ill-discipline, and so far tonight, some key mistakes and a little bit of indiscipline.
Four boys, hold, hold.
And it all makes it very interesting at the top of the table. Wigan still hanging on there with points difference. As it stands at the moment, all three, Wigan, Warrington, Hull KR, level on 28, but that points difference is narrowing as well, with Hull KR potentially racking up a big win against London here tonight.
Goal three.
Powell. Dancing away, but not getting far before he's got a hold up by a couple of his ex-teammates.
Fellas, hold.
Drinkwater. Williams, a dummy, and almost flashes through, but Nsemba grabbing a hold of the hips, and as Williams tries to get up, He didn't play the ball. He looks appealingly at the referee as if to say, Junior, help me down there, sir. But the referee doesn't agree, and it is Wigan's decision.
It's the right call, isn't it, from Liam Moore? Look, there was nobody on him. He tries to get up, play the ball, lose his foot, an incorrect play of the ball. So they'll be disappointed.
You just lose your balance.
As he's trying to get up, just loses the balance. He's looking at the referee, thinking, "Wow, well."
All the 10 fellas, please.
You've got me there, sir.
Go.
But Wigan have to come from very deep here, and Warrington's defence will be switched on.
Hold. No one. George, you're off, George! Two.
Walters.
Move! Hold his 10!
Here's O'Neill.
Goal, two.
Havard lining himself up as well now for the next carry, and bounces in and takes his punishment and wriggles free as quickly as he can to get that ball moving again. Inside for Nsemba. Paul Vaughan gets a hold of him and, with the help of a couple of others, stops the progress. Wigan tickling their way inside their opponent's half, and Ellis with a pass away, and Bird had run a good line. There was a bit of anticipation from the Warrington defence that allowed that to open up. Harry Smith puts the kick in the air, Dufty's underneath it and rises superbly well. Takes the tackle when he comes down, but has it safely in his hands.
Yeah, well taken under some pressure. One of the Warrington players jumped the line then, expected the ball to go further wide. You've got to make sure you keep your line intact. Don't try and solve the problems on your own. Tyler Dupree onto the field now, so there's two new fresh fellas on centre field. You'll be looking for one of the Warrington forwards to come off the bench pretty soon.
So, lead 12-0 against St Helens, good heavens. There's a kick out of dummy half by Powell. Eckersley with an easy catch, and Eckersley to bring it back as quickly as he possibly can, and he goes searching over there to see if he can find a bit of daylight, but he can't. So Ferryman picks up and feeds it on to Miski, and Miski.
Two, move up a square.
Just go about the job pretty well. The Warriors behind on the scoreboard. Tyler Dupree now just trying to get forward. He's desperate to get to the ground and play the ball quickly for Brad O'Neill.
It is all rather slowed up a bit. Jordy Crowther looking and looming over the top of him. It's back on the inside for Walters. And here's O'Neill again. This is Ellis, who's got a pass on him. He's got a surge on him, but neither of those in evidence. But he has got that ball away. It's juggled by O'Neill, but it's kept alive. Ty comes in, and it'll be another set of six. Dupree gets it out to Fadimund, does dancing feet in a tight situation, but Warrington had their eye on him and weren't going to let him go. Five to go from here. And Nsemba with a big effort, big drive. O'Neill's having a look around. Wigan perched on the edge of what could be something special. Wardle carries it out of one tackle. Ty got back across there to make sure he wasn't going to go any further. This now is Walters. He's going to have a go himself. But too many in Warrington colours for that to be successful. Wardle again. Here's Smith. Drops it inside for Ellis, and Ellis bowls it out. Smith now will go searching on that right-hand side. The kick doesn't look as though it was going to be successful, because Warrington always seem to have that covered, and Ashton comes running away with it.
He'll be really disappointed that Smith is going across the line. He's looking for someone to punch the line and looking for that attacking shape that all good halfbacks do when you're near your opponent's line. Nobody was there, so he kicks the ball, and they just weren't on the same page as his then.
They had
rest
another
of his
couple
team.
Of plays there as well, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. I think he kicked on the third play. He said maybe the strong defence was frustrating them. He's called for something. No one's cutting underneath him. No one's offering themselves.
And meantime, Warrington begin their journey back to the other end of the field, but they've only one play to go. Powell puts it back, and Drinkwater kicking it out there. Marshall underneath it. And Warrington's line efficient enough to make sure that Marshall doesn't go beyond, what, 25 metres away from his own line. Interchange here because Patrick Mago is coming on to the field. I think it's Ellis who's gone off, I'm not sure. Yes, it is. Here's Mago.
Well, he can certainly can cause some disruption. Look at that, four plays trying to get into him, try and flip him on his back. That's quick play, the ball from him. even with those numbers around him.
Havard, well, that came out with some propulsion, that flick pass, and Fireman picking up the pieces, and a left foot step, and then a right foot step, almost taking him through. Warrington recover just in the nick of time, but Wigan come again here in the shape of Havard. Havard blasting at the door that remains on its hinges and locked, but only just. O'Neill, now with Smith. Smith puts it up again. Marshall's going hunting here. More in a defensive mode as much as anything else. Waits for Fulis to catch that and make sure that Warrington have to start from that position.
Well, Josh Fulis knowing that he's just got to get down to play the ball as quick as possible.
Well, Lee 18, St. Helens nil. Good heavens, that could be quite a result. What would it be? Five defeats on the road for St. Helens if they lost tonight?
Never happened before. Unheard of in Super League.
Five in a row had very different connotations at St. Helens not that long ago.
Four. Move now! Hold, hold!
There's Drinkwater. Warrington looking to blast away from trouble. Wigan looking to tighten things up in defence. Well, they've done a good set here in defence, Wigan, so far, because
40.
Warrington have to kick from there on the last play. So when Eckersley catches this, he can advance quite close to the halfway line, and Wigan have a good starting position.
You know, he's an exciting young player, isn't he? There's a lot of talk all the time about French and Field, but Zach Eckersley, wow. I think he's got speed to burn. He's one for the future. His dad, actually, Chris, played for Warrington back in 1996.
Six again, and the ball!
Another set of six. That'll help Wigan's cause. As Walters takes it forward. Here's O'Neill, Farrell. He's just going to totter in and occupy the minds of three defenders.
Hold now, wait! Give me a step, Sam.
Position taken. Mago tries to step away from Crowther, who's not... Well, he's not stopped him, but has slowed him down, but Mako still with all that enthusiasm and still with all that battle and determination. And again, just lifts the mood amongst the Wigan fans. Here's Smith, pops it back. Dupree can't get away. O'Neill again. Smith. Mago's going to have another go. Full of brightness, full of light, having arrived from the interchange bench not that long ago. But this is the last play. O'Neill spins it back. Smith will carry it in, puts it out to Farriman. Oh, it's an interception! It's an interception, and Matty Ashton, who's one of the quickest men on the field, is going to be chased, but he's not going to be stopped. It's going to be another Warrington try. Wow! What are we watching tonight? The primrose and blue are blossoming just at the moment. Deep into this first half, they're a long way ahead of their rivals. 16 points to 4.
Well, outstanding. Won the last four games coming into this competition. It looked like they were going to be outnumbered. The setup play from Wigan centre field was going to that right-hand side. Ashton knew that they were outnumbered. He had to position himself in that line of where he was going to pounce and who he was going to nominate and choose when he jumps the line. They go to that right-hand side. Harry Smith with the ball to Farrimond, and he's trying to get that 2-on-1. And there's the look from the coach, Matty Pete. Everyone knows as soon as that man gets hold of it, there's no one going to stop him from scoring his 10th Super League try of the year. Tries in three successive games for this man, a man who has been absolutely on fire, full of confidence. Ever since he made the move from the Championship, Swinton, stepping up to play for Warrington and also represent his country now. Wow, you could see the look from Liam Farrell as well. The youngster throws the ball, he's disappointed.
Well, the only thing that was going to stop him there was a hamstring pull, wasn't it? Because no Wigan player was going to catch him, given the start he'd been given and given his burning pace.
Yeah, his quality, isn't he? You know, just to focus on what you've got to do in your job, and you've got to defend what's in front of you to make that decision to go for the ball. The youngster, Jack Farriman, he throws that ball. It's manna from heaven for that man.
Well, there's a bit of thinking to be done by those standing behind their own goal line at the moment.
Hey, look, and what I'll say about that young man, I've watched him. He was 2023 Young Player of the Year for Wigan. He's a quality player. Senior players make mistakes like that. You've got to back yourself. When you see an opportunity, you think it's on, go for it.
Stay in this rhythm.
And how much of this performance from Warrington tonight owes its roots to what happened in that Challenge Cup final when they admitted they hadn't turned up, but the occasion got to them.
It still haunts you. Yeah. It still haunts you as a player to lose on the big stage against one of your nearest and dearest, and you want to be challenging and you want to be playing in finals, you want to be lifting silverware at the end of those 80 minutes. And Josh Foulis and his side, they look a different beast this year under Sam Burgess.
Foulis strokes it with confidence and rightly placed confidence. Flags are up. 18 points to 4. A 3-score lead on the back of what we've just seen here.
Well, no matter what happens when you're defending, you've got to work hard. It was a 3-on-2. The youngster goes for the play. It doesn't quite come off. Ashton gets the ball, and that's it. They're gone. Sam Burgess last week talked about throwing a lot of shape, attacking shape at the teams that you play, also defensive shape and structure, what you've got to do. You've got to make decisions. Ashton made the decision, and it come off right for them.
Well, we saw that. Oh, that's Musgrove has been taken perilously close. He's managed to offload it, and there was a Wigan hand on that as well. So Warrington are riding their luck here.
Well, there you go. When things go for you, they go for you, just as you thought Musgrove was getting knocked off the sideline. He manages to offload the ball, keep it in play, and it comes off of him, Danny Walker.
Well, St. Helens going from bad to worse and from good to better from Lee's point of view. 20 points to nil now in the first half.
All those boys hold.
And Hawkingston Rovers are still leading by 16 points to nil against London. And remember, that has an influence here as well. To reiterate, any one of three could be top of the Super League table tonight. Although Wigan do have a game in hand, of course. But then the flip side of that is they've got a congested fixture list coming up as well, haven't they? That game in hand is against Lee, which they play on the 6th of August, 5 days after they play Huddersfield and 4 days before they play Leeds. So that will test them. Farrell. This is O'Neill. Maker. Now Havard. Havard can't wander too far before Warrington's defenders do their job. O'Neill again. This is Eckersley who offers this up, and it's almost a standing start for Sam Walters.
It's a bit of a poor set, this, from the Warriors.
And Smith will try to end it with a kick towards the corner, but Dufty always got to collect it. And now, how good is the Wigan line? Well, it's decent enough, and Warrington start from there. But it's almost as if we've seen Wigan lose self-belief in the last match and a half against Hull, and this one, they've been so out of character.
Do you know, you're looking around, like, obviously your nine needs some direction of what, who wants it, when they want it, where they want it. And there's no real communication. And that last set of six probably summed it up. George Williams now with a carry from the rope, looked a bit high. It is high, says the referee. Patrick Mago, contact with the head. George Williams just goes forward, uses footwork. You can see he just comes in, just a swinging arm. That's just enough for the referee, Liam Moore. And again, building him a bit more pressure.
Okay, mate, let's go.
The Warriors are worried just at this moment. Warrington Wolves are flying high. 14 points the difference. That's mendable from Wigan's point of view, but Warrington score again, and suddenly it becomes very, very difficult. It's hard enough as it is. Walker switching it back to Drinkwater. And here comes an athletic carry forward by Musgrove. Well, there's some talent. A talent up there in the gantry at the moment. And Bevan French, you can see those stats. 77% his side win when he plays. Only 57% when he doesn't. And out at the moment with a hamstring injury, which could see him missing for a good few weeks yet. Musgrove pushing hard. Held up. Just kept at bay. Walker. Spins it. That's not the first time Williams has received a difficult pass, and this time it ends up with an error. And he's having a look at his teammate and looking at his ankle as if to say, I don't want it down there, Danny.
Do you know, I've seen him quite a few times recently when mistakes like that have happened. Or people haven't just been pushing up, supporting him. He said on that occasion, Danny, I don't want it down there in my feet. I want it in my hand. I want to attack. I want to look up. I don't want to have to look at and readjust my hands and readjust my run and my stride for where the ball is. Got to be better. If we want to be the top team in the competition, we've got to nail players like that down near the line.
So Wigan again in a difficult spot. They have the ball, but a long, long, long way away from where they want to be, and the intensity of Warrington's defence just keeps at the same level.
Yeah, nice tackle from Adam Allroyd, then just stopping Sam Walters in his stride, and again just getting into Junior Semba before he gets into his stride.
Mega
George on the way,
pushing and getting a few extra yards after contact, but then has to taste a bit of grass as his face is pushed in the ground. Havard, he can't extricate himself from those onrushers, so Wigan have one to go. And Smith's under a little bit of pressure from Crowther, but he still gets a kick away. Safely patched by Thewlis.
Well, he's not going to make the same mistake again, is he? Positioning himself back down there. That was a good set of six as well defensively, just 29 metres that the Warriors were able to make, carrying the ball with five strong ball carriers.
Just over a minute left to play in this pulsating first half. Just the big games coming thick and fast. We've got another one next week, Warrington against Old Kingston Rovers. In terms of defining what's happening at the top end of the table. And the offload from Nicholson is hunted down. Wardle has it back. There's a bit of frustration from the Warrington camp this time, but that will be redoubled with the frustration from the Wigan camp, having seen that. Mistake follows mistake.
Yeah, well, the youngster, look at the, there's an offload here. Luke Yates is looking down saying, look, I'm out of the play. Who's got it? He's got to get on that ball. Then the next play, Farriman makes a mistake, drops the ball. Well, they get to half-time here. The scoreline will be as it is. But what a half for Warrington.
Let's get them boys, please.
16 seconds with the clock stopped, so at least one play here. Williams with a little bit of a skip in his step.
Move!
We're going to see a big kick here. From Drinkwater, no, they're searching down this right-hand side. Here's Ty, and he's tackled out of play. Duffy's asking, I think, where Josh Thewlis was in support there. But what a half, and what a statement that Warrington have made so far here tonight. They have dominated this huge game at half-time. It's Wigan 4, Warrington 18.
Dave Terry, thank you very much. Yes, the clash of round 19 has
in this next 40 minutes. It ain't a definitive night by any stretch of the imagination. Whoever's top tonight will not be crowned league leaders, Shield winners. But it goes a long, long way to answering the questions. Those questions about Warrington's mentality that has gone on for years now. But we're getting another waft of evidence tonight, Terry, that this is a much tougher minded Warrington team this year than we've seen previous iterations in years gone by.
Yeah, absolutely. They're a different beast under Sam Burge. I keep saying it all the time. You saw what they did and what they put themselves through in pre-season in preparation for this Super League game. Well, Wigan are going to come out firing. Last week, Wigan started both half poorly. They conceded a try after 4 minutes. They were down 18-4 at half-time. You'd expect them to come out and fire a few shots early on in that second half. Then after 2 minutes, they conceded a try. It can't be like that in this game. Otherwise, Warrington will just blow them away.
Well, their mentality has been tested many times, and they've come up trumps Wigan. But it is Warrington and Crowther who has come up with the early mistake. And it's Wigan's turn to tap shoulders and nod heads and put themselves in a very good position.
Well, they'd be disappointed with this Jordy Crowther. He's got hold of the ball. There were hands around the ball, but he's got to have a tighter grip on that. That's a mistake. Sam Walters, Brad O'Neill involved. He's made the mistake.
But they've not scored points, they've not conceded any points, they've just got to come up with a strong defensive set of six here and solve all the answers that what the likes of Harry Smith's going to throw at them.
Okay, Harry.
Six plays that could make a big difference to the game tonight. They're going left for Wardle. Huge strike weapon. But Warrington's defenders are over there in numbers to make sure he, even with his footwork, he ain't getting through. Marshall back to Smith, and now Havard will straighten things up. There's three of them there ready to greet him. So that's two plays. Mago was left, but they come right instead. And Smith and now Nsemba. And Nsemba, who's got so much muscularity and enthusiasm, but thwarted for the moment. And it's a knock-on, knock-on, and it's Warrington's turn for self-congratulations. Wigan were given the opportunity, they've spurned it.
And that's it. You celebrate that mistake like you've scored a try. The bit of the bobble at the play of the ball, right in front of the referee. The nod of the head from the coach, Matty Pete, knows that that's a chance that's gone missing.
I was going to say, doesn't that look say it all in terms of mood at the moment?
Yeah, absolutely. He's coming into this game on the back of what he said last week, where they were sloppy. The errors, unforced errors, that were not like what a team at the top of the table would make. And here's a high shot now, is it? Or is it offside?
Well, it compounds the mistake by offering Warrington very easy yards here. They were under pressure right at the start of this second half, exactly where Wigan wanted them. And through Wigan's mistake and then followed by indiscipline, they've just let them off the hook completely.
Well, Harry Smith just too quick out of the blocks for Liam Moore. And I look at that on the back of putting a team under pressure. They're now over the halfway line just on the back of that easy penalty.
So Warrington's chance to turn the screw their way. Tighten the pressure that is building on this Wigan side at the moment. Remember, a three-score difference. 18-14, so Wigan having to score three times and not concede to get themselves ahead in this game.
Back up, hold.
Certainly not impossible, but it is improbable at the moment from what we're watching. Things can change. Williams puts it back, Dufty, Lindop steps inside, and Lindop suddenly got clear view of the line, and he's in for his second of the night. Look at that celebration. They know what that means. They know how important that could be, young and old. It's been a long time between drinks and a Warrington championship. But under that coach and with this young clutch of players coming through, I dare to ask the question, is this their year?
Do you know, Dave, you've nailed it. Do you know, we've seen Warrington over the years just buy players in, spend the money, but they've never really invested heavily and bought into the youth setup at Warrington. They made the mistake, they go down the other end of the field, and Aaron Lindop, you just have a look at this, he rides a tackle, he gets through the line, and there's no panic from the youngster. We said earlier, he's a quality player, saw him on debut round one when he played in the south of France, desperate to give him man of the match. I thought he was exceptional, and you just look at that youngster. You build a club on players like that going forward, and what a player and what a start.
1 minute,
he's very calm and very collected, isn't he?
Oh, he's dancing
getting ahead
inside.
Of himself, even if the rest of us are.
No, he's dancing inside. You know, he's really proud of his play. He's got a really good rapport with his side. And he knows what they've got, he knows what they can give, and he doesn't ask too much of them. And they've come out there, and this is a, like I said, poor start in the first half from Wigan, poor start in the second half, exactly the same as last week. And that's what will disappoint their coach, Matty Pete.
Well, they are not quietening for this kick. They're fairly confident Josh Dulis will kick it, despite the racket they're making. Simply enough, and they're... confidence well-founded again. 4 out of 4 for him. 24 points to 4. Warrington are leading here, Terry.
Well, incredible. Not many people expected this. You looked at the Wigan side, you thought they were just going to play the power game and go straight through them, go straight for them. Well, Aaron Lindup scores his second try in this game. Everyone celebrates. It's a huge, huge 45 minutes so far for them.
Well, by my calculation, they are now not only locked on points for matches won, it'll be 28 points each, these two clubs. They're now locked on points difference. But London are doing their job against Hulkingston Rovers, so stymieing Hull KR's ambitions of being top of the table at the end of the night.
Yeah, it's a great
competition. Anything could happen.
It's a great competition, isn't it, this year? You turn up at games, you don't know who's really going to win, but you'd always expect when Wigan and Warrington play, it's going to be a classic. And the Warrington team, well, certainly they are taking this game, helped by the fans, to the Warriors.
One less play, but this is as it stands at the moment. As you can see, locked at the top. The advantage to Wigan is points scored, and the fact that they've got a match in hand, of course. But there are questions now where there seemed only certainty less than 2 weeks ago. It's going to be a race to the finish.
Well, Warrington now try and be disciplined. Look, I was just about to say, get off the line and get in front of the Warriors, but stay on side with the referee. And he's been consistent. You can see Zane just to the right of the referee, above the referee. He's offside.
Hold.
Zane Musgrove, that's a soft penalty to give away.
Well, 24-4 down last week against Hull FC, and they staged an incredible comeback, Wigan, and very nearly snatched it. And they've got a lot more time in which to rescue this situation now. 33 minutes to go. This needs something magnificent from the Warriors if they're going to put themselves back well and truly in pole position. He knows that. And they are capable of that. But the way Warrington are playing tonight, they are not certain of that. Smith goes wide to Marshall. Ulis. And they drag him out of play. Numbers suddenly appeared, and Warrington get the ball back under their conditions.
I was just watching the set-up play, what they had. They had Farrimond over on the right-hand side, and it looked like a passive play. For then Patrick Mago got the ball, went across, looked like he was going to drop somebody off, then gives the ball to Smith, and then it's a big pass out wide. And all Warrington need to do is hold the player up and just drag him over the sideline, which they did.
Well, that deafening noise you can hear is all coming from our left. Warrington fans are determined to enjoy this. They're taking a seat for a moment there just to get their breath back. But they've been very animated and they remain very loud. Now it's Wigan fans' turn, and they felt that was a penalty their way, but it has gone Warrington's way.
Well, another penalty going in favour of Warrington. See, Foulis just makes a step. Tyler Dupree, with the high shot, says the referee. He acknowledges it and apologises to his teammates.
Drinkwater's kick is pretty good. So Warrington has set fair five inside their own half. Musgrove. Four plays to have a go again here, Walker. And Williams pops it back for that angled run of Holroyd.
Nice play at speed and a quick play, the ball to boot.
This is Yates. Suddenly gone from the heady heights. Hasn't he plunged into this Warrington side in this last couple of weeks? Williams puts it back on the inside and Nicholson will have a go. And one play. Wigan will be tested here. Trying to get off their line quickly. O'Neill tries to close things down, but Drinkwater puts it up in the air. It bounces and bobbles and came last off a Warrington hand. So it's a tap back on the 20, and Wigan can try and build again here.
We're looking for a bit of speed here with the youngster Eckersley. The ball's kicked over. Ashton can't really make a play for that ball to come down and put some pressure on those Wigan defenders.
This is Farrell.
Well, they just look so confident at the minute, Warrington.
It's O'Neill searching out, slipping over, and the referee is immediately calling on that, and this does not look good at all, because the way he went down there was no physical contact. He's clutching his knee.
Do you know, it's the reaction from the opposition players. Straight away, they put their hands up. They know one's going to jump on top of him. No one's going to go any further. They know that Brad O'Neill's got a bit of an issue going on. always looks worrying when it when there's no contact. Is it just a bit of change of direction from the youngster?
Well, the dreaded acronym ACL is something that every player really fears, and when it's a non-contact, you do worry about that. But Aaron Lindop has put his club in a terrific position. An early try in the first half, and then this strike just a few moments ago. Took that opportunity wonderfully well.
Yeah, just got rid of Abasmiski. No, he's normally a good defender, Abasmiski. Be really disappointed with the effort trying to stop the youngster.
So he's in Wonderland at the moment. He's in an altogether difficult place, because that will be very worrying, not just for tonight, but for the rest of the season. Have a look at this. Yeah. No contact.
He's falling, but you've made contact at the
end time. Yeah, clutching the side of his knee.
Fingers crossed that that young man is okay. He's 22 on Monday. No, he's been given that nine jersey. He's been playing at nine ahead of Cruz Lehman. Doing a decent job as well.
So the test just got bigger from Wigan's point of view. And again, they find themselves without a recognised hooker on the field, of course. We had this the other week against St. Helens. And Farrell, in his own half, was operating here, and Faramund was operating in the other end, but Tom Forber, the young Tom Forber, not available. Cruz Leeming was named near the 21, but not in the 17 tonight. So Wigan are doing it tough here, and that's a kick from Smith that is as a result of the pressure, because it's gone very high, but it's not gone very far forward, and Drinkwater can pick it up, and Warrington can start their set more or less from where the ball was kicked from.
Yeah, they don't get any distance on that kick at all, do they?
Paul Junior, go on.
Gonna be disappointed.
Jack, you're off.
You can't get that extra field position that they're after.
Move!
That'll do. It's Roderick Tye who's put down. Walker comes out of dummy half and taken on by Ashton.
Move!
Max Wood is on the field. I think it's the first time we've seen him tonight, isn't it? Walker again. Williams there for company. Tosses it out for Dufty. Dufty on for Tye. Tye making things interesting here by getting out of one tackle, but finding his way blocked by the second, and one play to go. Warrington knocking on the door again. Williams puts the kick into that in-goal area, and all Wigan can do is clear it away and find themselves, all things being equal, back under pressure from the dropout.
Well, simple play, effective play, playing the percentages, rolling the ball in behind the try line and getting another set of six, and having a look at the try line, examining it. George Williams now just telling everybody what he wants, what he wants from the players around him.
10 seconds.
So Smith with a drop. There was a little bit of confusion potential there, but Dufty called it safely in the end, and Wood will carry it back, and Warrington are building again here.
Well, if you're a prop forward, that's always the fullback's ball, that.
Play it, goal one.
Walker.
Yeah, I agree.
This is Yates.
Two.
The redoubtable Luke Yates, and Walker measures up into position again. Back it comes from Wood. Max Wood put down. Three to go. Walker picks up. Williams pops it back, and Crowther tries to angle back between two defenders, but sandwiched and put down again. And Walker switches left to Williams, who tosses it up for Dufty, and Dufty in a tight space gets that pass away, and it was released forward and then knocked on by Mago. So it will be Wigan who get it back.
Yeah, well, a lot of questions been asked of the referee, and he sticks by his decision. I've never seen a referee ever change his decision.
No, I'm not saying you do that.
He says that that offload from Dufty went forward. When he releases the ball, does it go forward? The touch is in a decent position, gives the call, a clear call to the referee. And you can just see the likes of Drinkwater and George Williams obviously asking the questions, but disappointed, because that's a chance that they had.
This is a huge 26 minutes to play in the 2024 Betfred Super League season. Warrington know that, Wigan know that,
one side in the ascendancy, the other desperate to scrap their way back into control. But it's Warrington who are turning up the heat again in defence. They are not giving Wigan an easy passage. Thompson runs it in, a cheer, almost an olay. Oh, that's good from Thompson.
That's great,
really
work.
Good.
Great work, metres after contact from him. Quick play the ball as well.
Havard now strides in, long-legged and strong as well. But wrestled down. Liam Farrell back in that dummy half roll. Farriman puts it back. Eckersley puts it wide, but the pass does not connect. A look of disdain almost from Abbas Miski. Delight from those Warrington players. And they have it back again on the halfway line here.
Again, rushed, sloppy. The ball goes forward. I'm a huge fan of Zach Eckersley. Scored a couple of tries last week. But he didn't quite nail that pass then, which he needed to. And I'm looking at Warrington as well here, Dave, and I'm just looking at a team that loves the defensive part of the game. Been really impressed with Luke Yates. Still not to go off the field. 55 minutes he's played, and he's in the thick of everything. 33 tackles he's made.
Hawkinson Rovers extending to 22-12. It's not the walk-away victory that some of us expected tonight. London have shown some valour. Closes the points difference a little from Hull KR, but they've got to score quite a few more if they are going to go top of the table tonight. Remains Wigan 1, Warrington 2, Hull KR 3. That's Yates, done really well.
Goal 3, time is good.
Walker comes out and drink water, puts it back to Williams. Duffy with a miss-out pass, and this can only end one way. Matty Ashton with the try. He'll celebrate that moment, because that is the moment that Warrington go top of the Super League table. What a night. What a difference this could make to the feel of this competition.
Well, great play. Matty Ashton scores the try. I'm going to trace it back through the run from Max Wood, the run from Luke Yates. Teams talk about playing on the front foot, which is winning the ruck, and defenders not being able to put pressure on the team that's got the ball. A nice ball from Duffy. A quality pass from the man at the back. That's his 16th try assist of the career. You look at Wood here. He doesn't get dominated, still makes a few metres, four players involved, can't quite flip him until the last second. He gets up, plays the ball, Yates comes up, he steps forward, says, right, I'll have a go. He gets a one-on-one tackle, plays the ball quickly, then all of a sudden, it's eyes up, they're playing, they're going, and Duffy just spots the mistake from Abbas Miski in the wrong position. And that man, well, the space out wide for him to score.
Second of the night for Matty Ashton. 16th of the year. There's some glum looks there. Wigan are on the way to a second successive defeat as it stands. And that's not happened since June 2023, when they lost to Catalan in the Magic weekend and then the weekend after against St Helens. But the good news for Wigan fans, they then won 13 of the next 14, finished top of the table and won the grand final. So do not write anything off. What we do know is that we have got a fascinating run in. Ulis. Swings his boot at that, but swings it wide. Four for Wigan, 28 for Warrington.
Plenty of willing players in that, those Warrington jerseys this year. And that ball from Duffy out to Ashton. Well, there was only ever going to be one winner when he gets on the outside of his man. And it's just been a real impressive 57 minutes from the start of the game, when they forced the first error from Liam Byrne, up to this point, and now they've brought back on the reinforcements in Paul Vaughan.
It's moving day in Super League, because Warrington confirming now top of the table, only 8 points difference. But look how tight that is. And again, we need to just underline the fact that Wigan do have a game in hand.
Well, you know, I can tell you, it's easy to get up for a game like Wigan. Every week, everyone wants to knock them off the blocks. Everyone knows that they've got to be absolutely bang on when they come here to play them, or they play them at home. And that's what Warrington have been.
Drinkwater. Back to Williams. Williams skips away from Dupree's attempted tackle and then puts a kick in, and Marshall just lets that roll out of play. But Warrington have got Wigan right where they want them again.
But again, there's a bit of composure from George Williams. He spots somebody coming out the line, trying to put some pressure on him. He just uses his speed, gets those injectors, goes off to the right side and puts a nice kick in that Marshall doesn't want anything to do with.
Some early hours viewing for the NRLW tomorrow, and then in the NRL, Cowboys Sharks at 8:30 a.m. Roosters against the Sea Eagles after that. And a double header from the Super League, Salford against Cass. Salford scrapping to stay in the top six contention. Castleford have been turning their season around. And then Catalan against Hull FC, which, you know, if Catalan win and Salford win tomorrow, and Saints lose tonight, could see Saints drop to, I think, sixth position in the Super League. It's just an imponderable table, you know, from a couple of weeks ago even. Things are changing so rapidly. Wigan might change their luck yet here. Eckersley, brilliant stuff from him. Waddle carries it on. Step on the inside from Miskin. Well, there's plenty waiting. One to go. Merriman helps it on to Smith, who goes left, and well, the run of Walters just ran out of room as Warrington defenders were across so quickly.
Well, two lovely passes though from Wigan, from one side of the field to the other, from Farrimond to Smith to the big man Sam Walters. But they just can't make any headway down there. They're not panicking, Warrington. They're mapping off, and this is some strong defence from the Warriors. Big, big challenges. Again, there's going to be another one here on Vaughan.
Well, Wigan might have got a little sloppy tonight and last week, but they've not lost their intensity and muscularity at this end of the field. Not by any stretch of the imagination. They really are turning it up now. Harvey Hill on the field as well.
How much will he be enjoying it? Max Wood, who just played the ball, released from Wigan in January, playing against them.
Well, the stats tell the story of the game, really, don't they? And Duffy's found a way to escape, but it's an obstructive run, so it's a penalty for Wigan.
Yeah, you just look at that possession, completion, meters, everything. Well, Duffy and Sam Walters just coming together.
Well, it's getting heated.
And Sam Walters just taking exception. I think Duffy throws the ball over the top and, like, hits him in the head. You know, and I say it. I say it all the time, and I look at situations like this. It's not a good look for the sport, for me. Back in the day, if you went into a melee like that, you were going to get punched in the face. But now everyone knows that they're not going to get punched in the face. So everyone comes running in, and it's just not a great look. Look, he throws him down. What?
Well, certainly some aggression there, and heads coming together.
Yeah, well, Sam Walters, they put heads together because he takes exception to Duffy throwing the ball over and hitting him in the face. Yeah. That's where it all started from. Yeah. You can just see. Yeah. Look, he just winds the situation up. I'll guarantee you some of these players won't be doing that if they run into that and they were going to get punched straight clean between the eyes.
Yeah, you miss it, don't you?
No, it just, honestly, I'm not condoning people getting punched, but I'm not condoning that either.
Captains, please, boys.
Well, the referee and his touch judges and the video referee all involved here.
Right, boys, what we've got here, we've obviously got this in back play. We've got both players coming head-to-head. It's rutting, OK? But it's caused by Matt Duffy throwing the ball, OK? So that's foul play, mate. The penalty's going against you guys now. As captains, we've got 17 minutes left of this game. George, I'm not finished, mate.
where there's very little involvement from me. Let's keep it that way. Eh? I'm going to put the responsibility as you as captains. You speak to your boys. Let's keep it controlled. Penalties going against Matt Duffy. Okay, mate.
He's a good man, isn't he, Liam Moore?
Well dealt with it, and rightly so. Like, he caused it all by just throwing the ball over the top. Look, there's a bit of verbals going on. Sam Walters just having a go at him, having a go at his fist, and that's what causes it all.
Wigan had a penalty already on front of the sticks. Not that it changed anything, because they were never going to kick the goal. But they can really ramp things up now, and you can hear other Wigan crowd are reacting as well. Can they get themselves implausibly back into this? They need to score four back-to-back without conceding. It's a huge task. It has to start somewhere. Does it start here? Thompson taking them close. Farrell now picks up and spins it back. Ellis trying to step away, can't see a way forward. Flicks it back. Smith now along the line. Bannerman, Wardle, what can he cook up? Put some problems into the minds of the Warrington defenders, but they're quickly dealt with. Warrington literally back on their own line here. Farramond again. Havard thinks about the pass, then decides he's going to take them on physically. Every fan in the crowd is baying now, trying to get their team to defend or attack. The pass is terrible. Wigan, through some kind of crazy footwork, still keep it alive. Playing it backwards, picked up by Farraman. Farraman with a chip and the chase. Goes chasing after it, Bian Semba. Dropped on by Ashton. Warrington have it back. Well, and my goodness, this is really turning up now.
Yeah, well, they nearly made something out of nothing. And again, this is going to be a big, big set of six for Warrington to control the ball. Young Lindop here putting his hand up and stepping up and taking the ball forward. Ashton does ever so well on the press for Semba. And we've seen that look a couple of times tonight, haven't we?
Well, there's some huge psychological blows to be landed in what's left of this game. And Warrington have just come up short. Wigan get it back again.
Well, George Williams just in now, just to Ben Curry and to everyone around him. Just saying, look, we've just got to calm down here. Don't panic. We know where we are. We know where the scoreboard is. We're in front. We've made a mistake. But we've not conceded a point. We're 30 metres out from our line, we're centre field. Let's deal with what's in front of us.
So Wigan head and feet. 15 out when we eventually get the ball in.
Shot clock off. Out, bring down! Well done, lads.
Farraman out, Wardle. Wardle now, shrugs away defenders. Good stuff from him, but held up. Farrell flicks it back into Ellis. Ellis just driving forward, urging his big body closer to that line. Three strong men stand in his way. Farrell. This is Smith. Eckersley's quick pass. It's another gift, but this time to the other winger. Gillis goes racing away. Is he going to be caught? I don't think he is. Marshall's in hot pursuit. But Fulis is over, and that surely wins the game on a big, big night for this season, and a big, big night for Warrington.
Well, that's a huge point in their season for me. They've answered all the questions. Can they actually back up against big teams away from home? They did it last week against Saints. They beat Leeds, they beat Huddersfield, they beat Hull in the last four games. Could this be the fifth win in a row? Sam Burgess, Richard Marshall and Martin Gleeson. Well, they've come up with a game plan that's come here and beat Matty Peat's men. You look at that scoreboard and you think that this Wigan team can't get back, surely can't get back into this game. It was some aggressive defence on their own try line where they come in and they just made the decision to make Wigan play. Eckersley throws the ball. He was under some pressure from Roderick Tye. The ball was thrown wildly out and it goes into the hands of Fulis and he comes up trumps. The second intercept try that they've scored in this game, the first from Ashton, the second from Fulis. And Fulis, well, he just backs himself, backs his speed, doesn't panic, always aware that he's going to be chased down, and he's just looking around him, where he's got to run, what angle he needs, and just as he's going over to score the try, gets hold of the ball in two hands. He's not going to lose that one.
They had a wobble around Wembley, didn't they, before and after and during that big occasion. Then they righted the ship with a 24-18 win against Hull. It was close and it was tighter than many expected. Then they ran Huddersfield ragged 48-0. Then it was a victory against Leeds. But then it was a question, have they got the mentality against the big sides? Well, they did for St Helens last week. And tonight, I think we can safely say they've done for Wigan.
Do you know, I just think, said it in the first half and I'll say it again, they look a tough side. They look a side that'll get into the grind with people. Under Sam Burgess, I think that he's laid him down a game plan and said that, look, I won't ask you to do anything, lads, that I wouldn't have done myself. And the players are there on every word that he says. And now you look at the scoreboard, you look where you're at, you're thinking, wow, does it get any better than this?
Well, over it goes, 5 out of 6. 34 points to Warrington, Wigan 4. This one gifted, but taken with both hands.
Which way, Harry? Got to go right. Are you in shot?
Well, they've had a couple of tries gifted to them.
Don't blame you.
But what I will say, it's aggressive defence that's forced them to make that play, which then they made that play, and someone's there to pocket it. Fulis, Ashton, both of them have got those interceptions, but it was strong defence that made the ball player play.
And Wigan, who, as we've said before, looked absolutely nailed on. It was all about who can finish second a couple of weeks ago. Not that anyone at the Wigan club would have given you that impression. I don't think they were getting ahead of themselves, but all observers around the game were saying, well, Wigan are unstoppable, it's them in first, who's going to finish second? They could be third at the end of the night tonight.
But one thing that you know about this Wigan side, when it comes to the grand final, the thing is, it October the 12th, they'll be there or thereabouts. They'll take this defeat and last week's defeat personal.
Release for Hull.
Well, some big scores elsewhere tonight as well. Hull Kingston Rovers 34-12. And St Helens losing 30 points to 4 at Lee. It's going to be 5 defeats on the bounce for St Helens. Miski with a catch. So that as it stands at table now.
Oh, he's dropped that ball.
Farrell picks up. Warrington congratulate themselves again on forcing that mistake.
Well, they're celebrating that. Again, it's as though, when you can see, is there a hand in there? Is there a bit of a tug? Yeah, there is. That should have been a penalty to the Warriors. The ball was stripped from Curry. But they get away with that on the blind side of the referee. And he knows that he's made the mistake, Miski. Doesn't need anybody telling him.
So this is the way things have changed. Hawkingston Rovers are only 8 points away from going up into second place. As we keep saying, nothing definitive tonight. No silverware is going to be handed out at the end of this one tonight, but it's just an illustration of what we've got going forward. Williams, quick hands, Duffy! And loose hands from Pulis.
Well, I talked about that aggressive defence, and when you pull the trigger out wide and you come in, you're hoping to get the man who's going to pass the ball, you're hoping to rush him to make that pass a sloppy one, and that pass was a sloppy one behind Pulis. And he couldn't quite just take it in. He did the ball in front of him, so he didn't break stride.
Well, we've seen that injury for Brad O'Neill a little earlier, and Jenna down on the sideline. I think you have news.
Yeah, Woodsy, it's exactly as we expected. Well, what looks to be quite a serious knee injury. He will go off for scans to work out the extent, but he's not in a great way.
Thanks, Jenna.
Oh, that's sad.
It looked sad. It looked awful right from the start, didn't it?
Fine, bad read that.
Through the legs of Eckersley, picked up, and a bit of basketball from Wigan, and Marshall's on his travels, done well, deep inside that Warrington half, but he's surrounded by Warrington defenders, but he has got a penalty.
Yeah, it's the tip tackle, isn't it? You know, Duffy, he gets it. Marshall, you can just see, just puts him in a dangerous position. He's trying to apologise. You can see, he lifts him. His head goes into the ground.
Duffy's just intimating to the referee that he thought Marshall put his head down in there.
And to be fair to Matt Duffy, he was first, he wanted to go out and apologise to the to Liam Marshall. The ref said, look, you've got to leave him. If he makes any attempt to try and lift him up or help him up, he'll be sent from the field.
Well, he's lifted his legs, so it's a penalty. Wherever Marshall's head is, that's a penalty.
Yeah.
The video referees having a word here as well.
Yep. Cheers, mate. Matt Duffy. George.
So, reminder, the video referee can get involved if he thinks there's a card.
Is it me from the group? Mate, you, it's hit to go above the horizontal and his first contact is the shoulder. That's a sin bin.
It is a card, so Duffy's off for 10 minutes.
Look, what you'll say is that it's been consistent all year. Not that I agree with it, but probably Matt Duffy knew what was coming then. Well, he picks him up, he goes into position, he goes, Liam Marshall himself tucks. He, like, makes it look worse. Like, initially though, when he's going down, he's not going to go into that position. He flips over, Duffy's in the sin bin for 10 minutes. Let's crack on for the last 8 minutes.
Well, Warrington are getting used to playing with 12 men. Sending off and a sin binning last week. Been told that Paul Vaughan's got off for an HIA. Oh, he's in Semba. Obstruction. Obstruction. The way seemed suspiciously clear.
And Semba, he just overruns that ball, doesn't he? He sees the line, sees the gap. He's just trying to thread him, his big body through it. And he goes through Wood and Holroyd, but the pass is ruled to be forward.
Shot clock on.
Wow, look at that. Lee 36, St. Helens 4, resurrecting Lee's vague hopes of getting in the six. But what's it doing for St. Helens? Good heavens.
Probably giving Paul Welland sleepless nights, isn't it?
As we heard earlier, Jack Wellsby gone off injured in that game as well. I'm not sure how serious that was. Mark Percival has spent in this spell in the sin bin. Walker.
Four. Move. That will be Liam.
So that table is not looking great for St. Helens because, as we said earlier, Catalan and Salford both win tomorrow. Saints suddenly drop to sixth, only 2 points above Leeds, and it would be unthinkable for St. Helens not to make the playoffs. There has not been a Super League year when grand finals have been around that they haven't made the playoffs. Thank you, by the way, to Ian Proctor for that stat, always on the ball.
I actually whispered that in his ear, then Dev. Don't worry.
Five and a half minutes to go. Smith tries to put one over the top for Miskey, who's got a corridor to run into, but that's stopped.
Goal three.
Wardle. Ellis spins it back, Farrell throws it out. Well, they're looking wide through Marshall. Marshall puts the kick back on the inside, but Drinkwater's underneath it, dodges away from Thompson. Can't get away from Eckersley.
Well, they've had everything covered, haven't they, in this game. A professional performance, a penalty that they'll receive it. And markers aren't squirt. Warrington just trying to play the game at some speed, and you can just see that they couldn't quite get set then. What have Warrington got now? The last 4 minutes, still looking to pile on the points or just get to the final whistle, and that'll do them.
All now, bulletin, hold, goal.
Ty taps, has a go. So Warrington start another set just inside their opponent's half. Kingston Rovers now leading 34-16, by the way, against London. Drinkwater. Here's Wood again. Max Wood held up.
He's been good, hasn't he? No, he's not the biggest. He's hard to handle.
Well, penalty. Well, Kate Ellis is astonished that the referee's given that. Thought it was a loose carry, but the refs adjudged that it was ripped out.
I said, hard to handle. He's not the biggest. You see Cade Ellis' hands. Oh, winning ball. 2 points Warrington deciding to go for here.
Lee 40, St. Helens 4.
Wow, that's a score, isn't it?
There's some strange things happening in this league this year. Make no presumptions about what you're going to be watching over the next few weeks. Literally anything can happen. Look at those Warrington fans, troubled in hope and expectation tonight, but Wigan fans are absolutely down on their seats. Very little to cheer. Liam Marshall's try in the 13th minute when they got it back to 4 points to six, but after that, it has been all Warrington. And that is the result. Wigan fans leaving early. Seen enough.
When you look at the next few games for the Warriors, Huddersfield next, then they got that rear-end game against Leigh. When they play against them, and I tell you what, after the result tonight for Leigh against Saints, they're going to be pretty confident.
Well, Huddersfield had a setback last night, didn't they? But under Luke Robinson's first game in charge a couple of weeks ago, they got a win. Luke Robinson's here tonight, by the way, watching on as that's put wide by Thewlis. And then the way Lee are playing at the moment, as evidenced by that victory over St. Helens. And then the game after that is Leeds away for Wigan. And are they on the way back?
And then they've got Saints at
and
Magic.
And then Saints at Magic.
Wow.
Oh. That's a shocker. I mean, to be fair, he has to go short. Yeah, there's nothing left in the game. Try and create something, but all it's done is given Warrington prime position again. George Williams came dashing in there. I think he was hoping for a quick tap. Warrington looking to strike again. Into the last minute of an astonishing night. Looking for a final flourish here. Walker's having a look around. He's got time to have a look around. Spins it out to Drinkwater. Williams stepping back on that left foot, but old mate Farrell grabs a hold and drags him down. Walker straightened up, driven in by Wood. Walker's there again, last play, could be the last play of the game. Back it comes. Williams, I think he was thinking about a drop goal, but Ty picks it up, and Ty running through some ragged defence, and Ty might just have finished it with a try on the line. The referee has seen enough. What a way to finish an astonishing performance. They might be up to 40 points here. They're already at 38. Well, he's seen enough, and he's heading for the dressing rooms. Warrington have made a massive, massive statement tonight.
Absolutely, totally agree with that comment. Roderick Ty scores the try, new 12-month deal in the bag. That's the icing on the cake. Right in front of those Warrington fans, and let me tell you, I've not heard them that vocal for years and years. But they have got some belief. They were setting up for the 1 point. George Williams was hurried. He gives the ball out wide to Roderick Ty, uses really good footwork to get over the line, get rid of three Wigan defenders. And it's just been clinical from start to finish from Warrington. Wow, what a performance. What an 80 minutes.
Well, have a look at that celebration. The kick's gone wide. The coach with a shake of a hand and a little word from two men who very well might meet again before the season's honours are decided. They had a wobble at Wembley, did Warrington, but my goodness, are they big game ready now? You bet they are. Have